The value of goods are expressed in money, while the value of money is expressed in goods. Money and goods are clearly not the same thing, but are exactly opposite things. Goods are wealth which you have, and money is a claim on wealth which you do not have. Goods are an asset, money is debt. If goods are wealth, then money is clearly not wealth. It is actually negative wealth, and maybe even anti-wealth. Carol Quigley. This is perhaps one of the most important lessons that you will learn before the dollar collapse. Understanding the difference between currency and wealth will either doom you to generational poverty, or it will create generational wealth. There will be no in-between, as there will only be haves and have-nots. Gone will be the middle class of think-they-haves. Of all the contrivances devised for cheating the laboring class of mankind, none has been more effective than that that deludes them with paper money. Daniel Webster. All currencies are merely future claims on wealth, since they only have exchange value and no use value. Yet all goods have both exchange and use value. The only way for a currency to be useful is to exchange that currency for something that you can use. Outside of its exchange value, it is intrinsically worthless. Yet real wealth has use value even when it's not being used as a means of exchanging value. Lenin was certainly right. There is no subtler, no surer means of overturning the existing basis of a society than to debauch the currency. The process engages in all the hidden forces of economic law on the side of destruction. It does it in a manner in which not one man in a million is able to diagnose. John Maynard Keynes. The men that own this world know that in order for them to maintain control, they must keep all the wealth to themselves and have us chase after illusions of wealth. This process has taken nearly a century to detach humanity from understanding what real wealth is. Today there are very few that have ever even held a gold coin, much less own one. Many of the objects that they have are merely consumer products that are almost worthless the day that they buy them. The criminal elite first replaced real wealth of gold and silver with paper receipts for them in the form of gold and silver certificates. They then removed the claim of the real wealth by creating fiat paper backed by legal tender laws and the threat of violence. We know right off the bat that if someone has to threaten you to use it, it's probably something that you wouldn't do willingly. Now our money has become so detached from reality that most never even touch the paper claims on wealth that does not even exist. Paper is poverty and merely the ghost of money. Thomas Jefferson. If Jefferson were alive today, he would look at our money and say that it is only an illusion of a ghost of money. Over many generations, we have been systematically driven to chase after illusions of wealth that we think that we can exchange for real wealth for some time in the future. People build up digits on their screens hoping that they'll have enough future claims on wealth that they'll never have to work in the paper paradigm again. This has served the rulers well, as they create all sorts of distractions to keep us from ever seeing what real wealth is. The illusion of freedom will continue as long as it is profitable to continue that illusion. At the point that the illusion becomes too expensive to maintain, they will take down the scenery, pull back the curtains, they will move the tables and chairs out of the way, and you will see the brick wall at the back of the theater. Frank Zappa. When the silver ETF first came out, I was excited because I knew that silver was a great investment, and this would make owning silver much easier. I did not know then the difference between exchange value and use value, but I soon saw SLV as a way for the elite to once again get us to accept a future claim on wealth and not real wealth itself. The more that they can divert people away from real wealth, the more power and profits they will have. When bonds lose favor, they push stocks. When stocks lose favor, they push easy credit on real estate. When real estate falls, they push Forex trading. And now we have the biggest distraction of real wealth ever, the quadrillion dollar derivative market. That is an enigma of an illusion of a ghost of money. At the end of all these schemes, there will come a time where it is no longer profitable to maintain the illusion of wealth, and the game will end quite suddenly. It will send shockwaves through every aspect of our lives, and nothing will ever be the same again. All that will be left is the real wealth that you have in your friends, skills, and assets. All the things that we take for granted as we chase shiny lights that are used to control us. When I started with the Silver Bullet, Silver Shield, I saw the very nature of power and how individuals can free themselves from collective control. When you understand how focusing your energies on real wealth and how that is the basis for your independence from their control, you will start to become free. The final benefit of pulling their real wealth out of their system is that you deleverage their Ponzi scheme. You take away the basis for their power. They can pass around all the claims on wealth that they want, but at the end of the day, they will not deliver on those promises.
And you truly can construct a system which creates the savings that are required to build the real assets so that the retirees have real goods and services. We don't have a system that's working. We have one that basically moves cash around, and we can guarantee cash benefits. It's far out and at whatever size you like, but we cannot guarantee their purchasing power. And this is why the issue ultimately has got to be resolved in terms of, do we have the material goods and services that people will need to consume, not whether or not we pass some hurdle with respect to how legal financing occurs, because the financing is a secondary issue, and it's the means to create the real wealth, not an end in itself.
Once you understand the simple lesson between real wealth and future claims on wealth, you will never be fooled again by any of their schemes, and you will be able to create true generational wealth.